A lot of the reactors that we see online today have been built out in the 1970s, and we haven't seen growth in reactor build out since then. It's important to understand the energy markets that we are currently living in to figure out why nuclear hasn't made a push so far. Nuclear accidents have definitely changed the public perception over time, and they do not help for sure because it's such a political thing. But apart from that, if you look at the energy buildouts that's happened, especially in the United States, and if you look at the generations that have been brought online, then you'll see a period between 2000 and 2005 where there was a massive buildout of natural gas power plants all around the United States. And I think combined, my numbers might be slightly off, but I think in those 5-6 years combined, there was around 200 gigawatts of natural gas power plants just built in the United States. And what led from there was just cheap natural gas prices, and nuclear has found really tough, and not just nuclear, even coal power plants have found it really difficult to exist in a market environment like this where natural gas is suddenly so cheap. So it just depends on like the build out that happens. And now I think the opportunity for especially advanced nuclear reactors would come probably, I think, in 2030s to 2040s. That's a time frame where a lot of these existing power plants that we have currently are going to retire. Especially, I mean, any predictions on energy markets generally are wrong, but so I don't want to say that. But I mean, looking at the trends, I think a lot of the existing plants are going to retire in 2030s. And that's where I also wrote this on a Twitter thread where I feel that's exactly the opportunity which a lot of these private companies in the advanced nuclear reactor space are trying to fight for. So that's another important factor apart from the accidents over time, which have changed public perception.